that kitchen's hot.
What, Essie?
I say that kitchen's awful hot. It's that new candy I'm making. It just won't ever get cool.
Do you have to make candy today, Essie? It's such a hot day.
Well, I got all those new orders. Ed went out and got a bunch of new orders.
My, if it keeps on, I suppose you'll be opening up a store.
Oh, that's what Ed was saying last night. But I said no. I want to be a dancer.
Well, the only trouble with dancing is it takes so long. You've been studying such a long time.
Only 8 years. After all, Mother, you started writing scripts about 8 years ago. So we started around the same time, didn't we?
Well, yes, but you shouldn't count my first 2 years because I was learning to type.
I think the candy's hottening up now, Miss Essie. Oh,
thanks, Reba. I'll bring some in, Mother. I want you to try it.
Finish the second act, Miss Sycamore?
Huh?
I said, did you finish the second act?
Oh, no, Reba. I just got Cynthia entering the monastery.
She was at the Kit Kat, wasn't she?
Well, she gets tired of the Kit Kat Club, and there's this monastery, so she goes there.
Do they let her in?
Oh, yes. I made it Visitor's Day, so of course anybody can come.
Oh.
So, she arrives on Visitor's Day and just stays.
You mean she stays all night?
Oh, yes. She stays 6 years.
6 years? My, I bet she busts that monastery wide open.
6 years later.
Mr. DePina!
Yeah?
Mr. DePina, will you bring up one of those new skyrockets? I want to show Miss Sycamore.
Sure.
Thanks. Hey, Penny, check out these new firecrackers. We sell them for 10 cents a string. Listen. Ooh, nice, huh?
Yes. Oh, Paul, dear, were you ever in a monastery?
No. No, I wasn't. But wait till you see these new skyrockets, too. I got gold stars, blue stars, a bomb, and then a balloon. Mr. DePina thought of the balloon.
Sounds lovely. Did you do all that today?
Sure. We made just about a... Oh, here we are. Look, Penny, it costs us 18 cents to make, and we sell them for 50. How many think we can make before the 4th of July, Mr. DePina?
Well, we got 2 weeks left. What day are you going to take this stuff up to Mount Vernon?
In about a week. You know, we're going to need a bigger booth this year. Got a whole lot of stuff made up. Come on, we're not through yet.
Mr. Sycamore? I'm afraid the powder chain was just too close to the balloon.
Well, we got the stars and a bomb in between.
But I don't give the balloon time enough. A balloon needs plenty of time.
Come on, come on. We'll go try it out in the cellar.
All right.
Mr. DePina, if a girl you loved entered a monastery, what would you do?
Oh, I don't know, Miss Sycamore. It's been so long.
Miss Alice gonna be home for dinner tonight, Miss Sycamore?
Oh, I don't know, Reba. Maybe.
Well, I'll set a place for her, even though she's only been home one night this week.
Yes, I know.
Miss Essie's making some mighty good candy today. She's doing something new with those coconuts.
Uh-huh. That's nice.
Let's see. 6 and Mrs. DePina. And if Mr. Kolenkov comes, that makes 8, don't it? Yes, I better set for 8.
Reba, I think I'm going to put this play away for a while and go back to the war play.
The war play. I always like that one. Boom! Boom!
They'll be better when they're harder, Mother. But try one. I want to know what you think.
They look lovely. What do you call them?
I think I'll call them love dreams.
Yes, that's nice. Oh, I'm going back to the war play, Essie.
Oh, are you, Mother?
Oh, yes. I've sort of got myself into a monastery, and I can't get out.
It'll come to you, Mother. Remember how you got yourself out of that brothel? The snakes look hungry. Did Reba feed them yet?
I don't... No, Reba, did you feed the snakes yet?
No, Donald's coming. He always brings flies with him.
Well, try to feed him before Grandpa gets home. You know how fussy he is about them.
Yes.
Oh, and here. Take Groucho and Harpo into the kitchen with you. Believe I'll have another love dream.
Mr. DePina was right about the balloon. It was way too close to the powder.
Would you like a love dream, Father? They're on the table.
No, thanks. Gotta go wash.
I'm going back to the war play, Paul.
Oh, really? That's nice. You know what? I want some stars in between the bomb. That ought to do it.
You know, Mr. Kolenkov says I'm his most promising pupil.
You'd think with 40 monks and one girl that something would happen.
Essie, hey, Essie.
Oh, that's lovely, Ed. Did you write it?
No, Beethoven.
It's lovely. It's got a lot of you in it. I made those new candies this afternoon, Ed.
Yeah?
You can take them around tonight.
All right. Now for the finish. This is me! How's that?
Oh, it's fine, Ed. Remember when Kolenkov comes, will you?
Ed, dear, why don't you and Essie have a baby? I was just thinking about it the other day.
I don't know. We could have one if you wanted us to. What about it, Issy? Do you want to have a baby?
Oh, I don't care. I'm willing if Grandpa is.
Well, let's ask him.
Labor play, religious play, sex play. I know it's here someplace.
I was right about the balloon. It was just too close to the powder.
Well, do you want anything printed today, Mr. DePina? How about some more calling cards?
Nah, I got the first 1,000.
Well, call on someone, will you?
All right.
What do we got for dinner tonight, Reba? I'm ready to print the menu.
Let's see, some cornflakes, some watermelon, some of these candies Miss Essie made, and some kind of meat. I forget.
I think I'll set up in bold-faced Shellingham tonight. But you know, if I'm gonna take those new candies around, I better print up some descriptive matter after dinner.
Do you think anybody reads those things, Ed, that you put in the candy boxes? Oh, here it is. The war play. Poison gas. That must be Donald. Look at Reba's smile.
Oh, the boyfriend, eh, Reba?
You're awfully cute, Donald and Reba. Sort of like Porgy and Bess. Donald!
Hello, Reba. Evening, everybody.
Hi, Donald. How you been?
I'm pretty good, Mr. Ed. And how you been, Miss Sycamore?
Oh, very well, thank you. Oh, Donald.
Yes, ma'am?
Have you ever been in a monastery?
Oh, no. I don't go no place much. I'm on relief.
Ah, oh, yes, of course. Yeah.
Here's the bottle of flies, Reba. Caught a big mess of them today.
You sure did?
I see you've been working, Miss Sycamore.
Yes, indeed, Donald.
And how's Grandpa?
Oh, just fine. He's over at Columbia this afternoon for the commencement exercises.
My, my. The years certainly do roll around.
M-E-A-T. What's he go there for all the time, Penny?
I don't know. It's so handy, just around the corner.
Oh, Donald. Mr. DePina and I are going to take the fireworks up to Mount Vernon next week. You think you can give us a hand?
Yes, sir. Only I can't take no money for it this year. Because if the government finds out I'm working, they'll get sore.
Huh? Hey, Ed. I had a wonderful idea while I was in the bathroom just now. I was reading Trotsky. It's yours, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. I left it there.
Who is it?
Trotsky. You know, the Russian Revolution.
Oh.
Well, it struck me as a great fireworks idea. Remember the last days of Pompeii?
Oh, yes. Palisades Park. That's where we met.
Oh, well, I'm going to do the revolution, a full-hour display.
Say.
Oh, that's wonderful.
The red fire's the flag, huh?
Sure, and his arm and his axe.
And the freeing of the slaves?
No, Donald. The Russian Revolution. Hello, Grandpa.
Well, sir, you should have been there. That's all I can say. You should have been there.
Was it a nice commencement, Grandpa?
Oh, it was wonderful. They get better every year. You don't know how lucky you are, you snakes.
Big classes here, Grandpa? How many were there?
Oh, it must have been about 2 acres. Everybody graduated. Oh, and the speeches were much more funnier than last year.
You want to hear a good speech, you go up and hear Father Divine.
Oh, wait till next year. They'll have him at Columbia.
Donald, will you go in and tell Reba that Grandpa's home now so he won't wait for Miss Alice?
Yes, ma'am. Reba! Grandpa's home! We can have dinner!
We made a new skyrocket today, Grandpa. Wait till you see it.
Evening, Grandpa.
Evening, Mr. DePina.
Didn't we make a fine rocket today, Mr. DePina?
We sure did.
I wonder why they don't have fireworks at commencements.
Oh, you don't need one. All it takes is a good commencement order to drown out a whole carload of fireworks. And say just as much, too.
Don't the graduates ever say anything?
No. They just sit there in cap and nightgown, get their diploma, and along 40 years or so, they just sit there and wonder, where am I?
Hello, Grandpa. Have a nice day.
Hello, Grandpa. Have a nice day. Don't I even get a kiss? Oh, I'll have a tomato, too. You know, I could have used one of these this evening.
Father?
No, thanks.
Mother?
Oh, no, thanks, dear.
Play something, Ed.
All right.
There was a letter key for you, Grandpa. Did you get it?
That's funny. I don't know anybody.
Oh, it was for you, though. It had your name on it.
Funny? Well, where is it?
I don't know. It's Grandpa's letter, Mother.
What, dear?
Where's that letter that came for Grandpa last week?
I don't know. I remember seeing the fish on it.
Who was it? Did you notice?
Oh, yes, it was on the outside.
Well, who was it from?
The United States government.
Wonder what they wanted.
There was one before that, too. There was a couple of them.
Well, if any more come in, just make sure I get them, dear.
Yes, Grandpa.
You know, I think I'll go out to Westchester tomorrow and do a little bit of snake hunting.
God is deceit, deceit is God.
What?
God is deceit, deceit is God.
Who says that?
Trotsky.
Oh, good. I thought you said it.
It's nice for printing, you know. Good and short.
G-O-D space I-S space T-H-E space.
And so, the beautiful princess walked into the palace and kissed her mother, and her father, and her grandfather.
Hello, dear.
Hello, Grandpa. And what do you think? They turned into the Sycamore family. Surprise. Oh, Alice, I like it.
Do you?
It's new, isn't it?
It looks nice and summery.
Where'd you get it?
Oh, I took a walk during lunch hour.
You've been taking a lot of walks lately. That's the second dress this week.
I just like to brighten up the office once in a while. No, I'm known as the Kate Francis of Kirby and Company. Well, what's new around here in the way of plays, snakes, ballet dancing, or fireworks? Dad, I'll bet you've been down that cellar all day, huh? Mm.
Oh, I'm going back to the war play, Alice. Oh,
really, Mother?
Ed, play Alice that Beethoven thing you wrote.
Did you know that you can mail a letter all the way to Nicaragua for 2 pesitos?
Really?
Kenneth, my virginity is a priceless thing to me.
Listen, everybody. Listen, I'm not home to dinner. A young gentleman is calling for me.
Really? Who is it?
Isn't that nice?
Well, I've tried everything possible to keep him from coming here, but he's calling for me.
Well, why don't you both stay to dinner?
No. No. I want him to take you guys in easy doses. I've tried to prepare him a little, but don't make it any worse than you can help. Don't read him any plays, Mother, and don't let a snake bite him, Grandpa, because I like him. And I wouldn't dance for him, Essie, because we are going to the Monte Carlo Ballet tonight.
Oh, can't do anything. What is he, President of the United States?
No, he's Vice President of Kirby and Company. Mr. Anthony Kirby Jr.
The boss's son.
Well, the boss's son, just like the movies.
That explains the new dresses.
And not being home to dinner for 3 weeks.
What, Sherlock Holmes?
Are you going to marry him?
Oh, yes, tonight. You know I'm going to go up and try on my wedding dress.
Is he good looking?
Yes, in a word. Oh, dear. What time is it?
I don't know. Anybody know what time it is?
Mr. DePina might know.
It was about 5 o'clock a couple hours ago.
I ought to know better than to ask you people. Will you let me know the minute he comes, please?
Of course, Alice.
Yes, I know, but I mean the minute he comes.
Well, of course.
Okay, well, be sure.
Well, what do you think of that?
She seems very happy.
Oh, I should say so. She's got it bad.
Wouldn't it be wonderful if he married her? We could have the ceremony right in this room.
Now, Penny. It's the first time he's ever called for the girl.
You only called for me once.
Young people are so different nowadays.
Oh. I don't know. Look at Ed and me. He came to dinner once and just stayed.
Anyhow, I think it's wonderful, don't you, Grandpa?
She certainly seems happy, if you ask me.
He must be crazy about her. Maybe he's the one that's been taking her out every night. That must be him. Never mind, Reba, I'll get it. Now remember what Alice said and be very nice to him.
All right, well, let's take a look at him.
Well, welcome to our little home.
How do you do?
I'm Alice's mother. Do come right in. Now, this is Mr. Sycamore, and that's Grandpa, and there's Alice's sister and her husband, Ed Carmichael. Now give me your hat and make yourself right at home.
I'm afraid you must be making a mistake.
How's that?
My car.
Wilbur C. Henderson, Internal Revenue Department.
That's right.
What may we do for you?
Does Mr. Martin Vanderhoff live here?
That's me.
Well, Mr. Vanderhoff, the governor would like to talk to you about a matter of income tax.
Income tax?
Do you mind if I sit down?
No, go right ahead.
Thank you.
Mother, is that Mr. Kirby?
Oh, no, it isn't, dear. It's an internal something or other. Pardon me.
Mr. Sycamore.
Oh.
What is it?
Excuse me. These things aren't going off. Look.
No, not now, Mr. Pina. Grandpa's busy. Pardon me?
No, Mr. Vanderhoff, we've written you several letters about this, but have not had any reply.
So that's what those letters were about.
I told you they were from the government.
According to our records, Mr. Vanderhoff, you have never paid an income tax.
That's right.
Why not?
I don't believe in it.
Well, you own property, don't you?
Yes, I do.
And you receive real income from it?
Yes.
Of between $3,000 and $4,000.
About that.
You've been receiving it for years.
1901, if you want the exact date.
Well, the government is only concerned from 1914 on. That's when the income tax started.
Well?
Well, it seems, Mr. Vanderhoff, that you owe the government 24 years back income tax.
Wait a minute. You can't go back that far. That's outlawed.
What's your name?
What difference does that make?
Ever file an income tax return?
No, sir.
Ah, what was your income last year?
$28.50. Wasn't it, Essie?
Yes, sir.
If you please. Now, Mr. Vanderhoff, you know there's quite a penalty for not filing an income tax return.
Penalty?
Well, say if I were to... Oh, mind me, I'm not saying I'm going to pay it, but just for the sake of argument, what's the government going to do with my money?
How do you mean?
Well, say if I walk into Macy's and I see something, there it is. What's the government give me?
Why, the government gives you everything. It protects you.
From what?
Well, invasion. Foreigners and I come over here and take everything you've got.
I don't think that's gonna happen.
If you didn't pay an income tax, they would. How do you think the government keeps up the army and navy? All those battleships.
The last time we used battleships was in the Spanish-American War. And what did we get out of it? Cuba. And we gave it right back. I wouldn't mind paying if it were something more, sensible.
Sensible? What about Congress and the Supreme Court and the President? We've got to pay them, don't we?
Not with my money, we don't.
Now, wait a minute. I'm not here to argue with you. All I know is that you haven't paid an income tax and you've got to pay.
Well, they got to show me.
We don't have to show you. I just told you. All those buildings down in Washington, Interstate Commerce and the Constitution.
The Constitution was paid for a long time ago. And Interstate Commerce. What is that?
There are 48 states. See? And if there weren't interstate commerce, nothing could go from one state to another. See?
Why not? They got fences.
No, they haven't got fences. They've got laws. My God, I've never seen anything like this before.
I'll pay about $75, but that's all it's worth.
You'll pay every cent of it, like everybody else.
Essie, listen to this.
And let me tell you something else. You'll go to jail if you don't pay. Do you hear that? That's the law. If you think you're bigger than the law, you've got an earth thing coming. You're no better than anybody else. And the sooner you get that through your head, the better. You'll be hearing from the United States government. That's all I can say.
Just watch out for those snakes.
Jeez!
How's that?
Oh, it's fine, Ed.
How did Ed sound to you folks?
I liked it.
My, he was mad, wasn't he?
It's not his fault. It's just the whole thing is so silly.
He forgot his hat.
Say, what size is it?
7 and an 8.
Oh, just about right for me.
Say, who was that fellow anyway?
This must be Mr. Kirby.
You better make sure this time.
Yes, I will.
Oh, I hope he's good looking.
How do you do? How do you do?
Good evening.
Is this Mr. Anthony Kirby Jr.?
Yes.
Well, Mr. Kirby, come right in. We've been expecting you. Come right in. Now, this is really Mr. Kirby. Now, I'm Alice's mother, and this is Alice's father. That's Grandpa, and that's Alice's sister and her husband. Now, Mr. Kirby, you know, all of us, give me your hat and make yourself right at home.
Thank you.
Is that Mr. Kirby, mother?
Oh, yes, it is, dear. He's lovely.
Oh, dear, I'll be right down.
Oh, do have a seat, Mr. Kirby. Oh,
thank you. I hope I'm not keeping you from dinner.
Not at all. Have a tomato.
No, thank you.
How about a
Stop!
No thanks.
I almost forgot to introduce Mr. Dabina. This is Mr. Dabina, Mr. Kirby.
Say, wasn't I reading about your father in the newspaper the other day? Didn't he get indicted or something?
Hardly that. He just testified against the Securities Commission.
Oh. Yes, I'm sure there was nothing crooked about it, Mr. Dabina. As a matter of fact, Alice has often told us what a lovely man your father is.
Well, I know my father couldn't get along without Alice. She knows more about the business than any of us.
You're awful young, Mr. Kirby, aren't you, to be vice president of such a big place like that?
Well, you know what that means, vice president. All I have is a desk with my name on it.
Is that all? Don't you get any salary?
A little. More than I'm worth, I'm afraid.
Oh, now you're just being modest.
Wall Street. It sounds pretty dull to me. How do you like it?
Well, I haven't been there very long, and the hours are short.
Just out of college, huh?
Well, I knocked around for a while, sort of just had fun.
What did you do? Travel.
For a while, then I went to Cambridge for a year.
England.
That's right.
Say, what's an English commencement like?
Very impressive.
They are, huh?
Well, now that the phone's over and I'm facing the real world.
Well, you've certainly got a wonderful start, Mr. Kirby. Vice president and a rich father.
That's hardly my fault.
Well, now I suppose you're ready to settle down and get married.
No, no, Penny. I'm sure Mr. Kirby has his mind set up.
He wasn't making up his mind for him, was I, Mr. Kirby?
It's quite right, Miss Sycamore.
You see?
You mustn't rush him, Mother.
Well, all I meant to say is he's bound to get married at some point, and suppose the wrong girl gets him.
Well, here I am, a vision in blue. Apparently you've all had time to get acquainted.
Oh, yes. We were just having the most delightful conversation about love and marriage.
Dear, I'm so sorry, Tony. I came as fast as I could.
I didn't mind it the least.
Damn those flies in the kitchen.
Oh, Miss Alice! You look beautiful. Where are you going?
I'm going out, Reba.
Stepping, huh? That must be Kolinkov.
Dear, I think we better go, Tony.
All right.
Grandpa, you take cream on your cornflakes? I forget.
Half and half, Donald.
Yes!
With little Rabiska!
Yes, sir, Mr. Kolinkov!
Good evening, everybody!
Good evening!
Grandpa, what do you think of it? I had had a letter from Russia. The second five-year plan was a failure!
Oh, I practiced today, Mr. Kolinkov.
Ah, Babaloa.
Well, if you'll excuse us, Mr. Kolinkov.
Ah, Miss Alice, I never have I seen you so magnificent.
Thank you, Mr. Kolinkov. Tony, this is Mr. Kolinkov, Essie's dancing teacher.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Oh, well, if you'll pardon us, Mr. Kolinkov, we're going to the Monte Carlo Ballet tonight.
The Monte Carlo Ballet? Stinks.
Oh. Yes, well, goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I'm glad to have met you all.
Monte Carlo Ballet.
Isn't Mr. Kirby lovely? Oh, come on, everybody. Dinner's ready.
I thought he was a nice fellow, didn't he?
Oh, he's so good looking.
And he had such nice manners. Did you notice, Paul? Did you notice his manners?
Oh, I certainly did. You're getting pretty personal with him.
Oh, now, Paul. Anyhow, he's a very nice young man.
Say, he looked like a cousin of mine.
Bosk, dear Cliff, then you have a Bella.
I think if they get married here, I'll put the altar right where the snakes are. You wouldn't mind, would you, Grandpa?
Not if the snakes don't.
Oh, no. They'll want to get married in a church. You know, his family and everything.
Yes.
Oh, I like the church weddings.
Quiet. Well, here we are. I want to thank you for everything you've done for us. We're all certainly getting along. I'm certainly much obliged to. Remember, all we ask is that we just go in our own sort of way and be happy. Of course, we got our help. But as far as anything else is concerned, we'll leave it to you. Thank you. So the second five-year plan was a waste.
Catastrophic.
Try the third time.
I could see them dance every night of the week. I think they're marvelous.
They are, aren't they? But of course, walking inside any theater gives me a thrill.
Well, it's been so lovely, Tony. I hate to have it over.
Oh. Is it over? Do I have to go right away?
No. Not if you don't want to.
I don't.
Would you like a cold drink?
Wonderful.
I'll go see what's in the icebox. Do you want to come along?
I'd follow you to the ends of the earth.
Just the kitchen is enough.
Why like it? You've done it very simply, haven't you?
Yes, we didn't know whether to choose Empire or Neo-Grecian.
So you settled for Frigidaire.
Yes, it's very easy to live with. Lucky you're not hungry, Mr. K. An ice box full of cornflakes. That gives you a rough idea of the sycamores.
Of course, why they make these bottle openers for singer midgets. I never could... all over my coat.
I'll take mine in a glass if you don't mind.
There you are, a foaming beaker.
Anyhow, it's cold.
Now, if you'd please be seated, I'd like to make a toast.
We're seated?
Miss Sycamore, to you. Oh,
thank you, Mr. Kirby. To you.
You want to know something?
What?
I wouldn't trade a minute of this evening for... all the rice in China.
Really?
Cross my heart.
Is there much rice in China?
Terrific. Didn't you read the good earth? Well, I ought to go.
Is it very late?
Very. I don't want to go.
I don't want you to.
All right, then I won't. When do you get your vacation?
Last 2 weeks in August.
I'll take mine then, too.
Really?
What are you going to do?
I don't know. I haven't put much thought into it yet.
Going away, do you think?
I don't think so. I like the city in the summertime.
Huh. I do, too.
But you always go up to Maine, don't you?
Oh. that's right. But, oh, you know what I mean, Alice. I'd love it if you were here.
Well, it'd be nice if you were here, too, Tony.
You know what you're saying, don't you?
What?
That you'd rather spend your whole summer with me than anybody else.
Was I?
Well, if it's true about summer, how do you feel about the winter?
Yes, I'd like that too.
Then there's spring and autumn. If you can see where you clear those, Miss Sycamore.
I might.
Well then?
Is that you, Alice? What time is it? Oh. Pardon me, Mr. Kirby. I had no idea. That is, I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
It's quite all right, Miss Sycamore.
I was just coming down for a manuscript. Then you can go right ahead. Ah, here it is. Sex takes a holiday. Well, good night, Tony.
Good night, Miss Sycamore.
Oh, I think you can call me Penny. Don't you, Alice? At least I hope so.
What's that?
It's all right, Tony. That's Father.
Oh. This time of night.
Any time of night. Any time of day.
You know, you're more beautiful, more lovely, more adorable than anyone else in this world.
Don't, Tony.
What? My dear, just because your mother... All mothers are like that, Alice. And Penny's a darling. You see, I'm even calling her Penny.
No, I don't mean that. Look, Tony, this is something I should have said a while ago, but I didn't have the courage to. I let myself be swept away because I loved you so.
Oh, darling.
Oh, no, wait, Tony. I want to make this clear to you. Listen, you're of a different world, a different kind of people. Oh, I don't mean money or socially. No, that's too silly, but your family and mine just wouldn't work, Tony. It wouldn't work.
All right. Have it your way, she can't dance. That's why they paid her all that money, because she can't dance.
Well, I don't call that dancing what she does. Oh, hello. How was the ballet?
It was fine, Essie.
Wonderful.
Hello there.
Hello.
Look, what do you people think? Ed and I just saw Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers. Do you think she can dance, Mr. Kirby?
Why, yes. I always thought so.
What does she do anyhow? Now look, you're Fred Astaire and I'm Ginger Rogers.
Essie, please.
I'm just going to use him for a minute. Now look, Mr. Kirby.
Essie, we all agree you're just as good as Ginger Rogers.
You see, Ed?
Yeah, come on, Essie. We're butting in here.
Oh, they've been together all evening. Good night, Mr. Kirby. Good night, Alice.
Good night, Miss Carmichael.
Good night. Oh, Essie, did you ask Grandpa about us having a baby?
Oh, yes. He said to go right ahead.
You see, Tony? That's what it would be like.
Oh, I didn't mind that. Anyhow, we're not going to live with your family. It's just going to be you and I.
No, Tony, it's never quite like that. You see, I love them. I love them deeply. Some people could just break away, but I couldn't. I know they do rather strange things, but they're gay and they're fun, and I don't know, there's just a sort of nobility about them.
Alice, you talk as only you can understand them. Why, that's not true. Every family has its curious little traits. My father raises orchids at $10,000 a bulb. Is that sensible? My mother believes in spiritualism. That's just as bad as your mother writing plays, isn't it?
It goes deeper, Tony. Your mother believes in spiritualism because it's fashionable, and your father raises orchids because he can afford to. My mother writes plays because 8 years ago, a typewriter was delivered here by mistake.
Darling,
and,
what?
And look at Grandpa. 35 years ago, he just quit business one day. He went up to his elevator, into the office, and came right back down. He just stopped. He could have been a rich man, but he said it took too much time. So for 35 years, he just collected snakes and gone to circuses and commencements. It never occurs to any of them.
Hello there, children.
Good evening, Mr. Vanderhoff.
Hello, Grandpa.
How's the weather? It ought to look like a nice summer's evening.
Yes, it's lovely, Grandpa.
Well, I'm off. I got a standing day with the policeman. Goodbye, Mr. Kirby.
Policeman?
Oh, we got a standing night every night at 12:30. I've known him since he was a little boy. He's really a doctor, but after he graduated, he came to me and told me he didn't want to be a doctor no more. He's always dreamed of being a policeman. So I told him, you go out there and be what you want to be. And so he did. Say, how do you like my new hat?
It's very nice, Mr. Underhall. Oh,
thank you. The government gave it to me.
Oh, sorry. I didn't know you folks was in here.
Oh, it's all right, Donald.
Reba kind of fancied some candy and oh, there it is. Y'all don't want any, do you?
No, Donald.
Thanks. Did y'all have a nice evening?
Yes, Donald.
Did y'all have a nice dinner?
Yes, Donald.
Was the ballet nice?
Yes, Donald.
That's nice.
Now, could you explain Donald to your father? Could you explain Grandpa? You couldn't, Tony, you couldn't. I love them, Tony, but it's no use.
Hey, there's only one thing you said that matters. That makes sense at all. You love me.
But Tony, I know so well.
But don't you think other people have the same problem? Everybody's got a family.
Oh, but not like mine.
That doesn't stop people who love each other. Darling, won't you trust me and go on loving me and forget everything else?
How can I?
Because nothing can keep us apart. You know that. You must know it. They want you to be happy. They must.
Of course they do, but they can't change. I wouldn't want them to change.
They won't have to change. They're charming, lovable people just as they are. Everything will work out. You're worrying about something that may never come up.
Oh, Tony, am I?
All that matters right now is that we love each other. That's so, isn't it?
Yes.
Well then.
Ew. Tony.
Now I'd like to see little Katie around here. You've been calling and getting engaged and whatnot.
What do I say?
Well, first you thank the young man for getting engaged to you.
Well, thank you, Mr. Kirby, for getting engaged to me.
And then you tell him what it was about him that first took your girlish heart.
The back of your head.
Huh?
Huh? It wasn't your charm and it wasn't your money. It was the back of your head. I just liked it.
Well, what happened when I turned around?
Oh, I got used to it after a while.
Oh, Alice. Think of it, we're pretty lucky, aren't we?
I know that I am. I'm the luckiest girl in the world.
I'm not so unlucky myself. Oh, dear. I ought to... Good night, darling. Until tomorrow.
Good night.
Isn't it wonderful we work in the same office? Otherwise, I have to be hanging around here all day.
Wouldn't it be funny seeing each other in the office tomorrow and going on as though nothing had happened?
It's a good thing I'm vice president. I can dictate to you all day. Miss Sycamore, I love you. I love you. I love you.
Oh, darling, you're such a fool.
Why don't you meet me in the drugstore in the morning? Before you go up to the office, I'll have a million things to say to you.
All right.
And then lunch. And then dinner tomorrow night.
Oh, Tony, what will people say?
It's bound to come out sometime. In fact, if you know good house stop, I'd like to do a little shouting.
Yes, sir, Mr. DePino, we did a fine night's work today.
That's what, 500 Black Panthers, 300 Willow Trees, and 8,000 Junior Kitty Bombers.
Pretty good. Oh, hello there, Alice. You just come in?
Oh, no, Father. I've been home for quite a while now.
Did you have a nice evening?
Oh, yes. I had a beautiful evening.
Say, I'd like you to take a look at this new red fire I just made. DePino, will you go turn off the lights? I want Alice here to go.
Sure.
Full effect.
What, Father?
I said, take a look at this new red fire. It's beautiful. Watch. There. What do you think of it?
Oh, yes, Father. Everything is beautiful. It's the most beautiful red fire in the world.
Job and stick it right up your...
I'm ready to read you the new play now, Miss Wellington. Anytime you are.
Just a minute, Day. Just a minute.
Well, the only problem is, and I hope you don't mind my mentioning this, but you don't drink while you're acting, do you, Miss Wellington? I'm only wondering, of course.
I'm glad you brought it up. Once the play opens, I never touch a drop. Minute I enter a stage door, the bottle gets put away. Until intermission.
How long have you been on this stage, Miss Wellington?
All my life. I've played everything. Ever see Peg in My Heart?
Yes.
I did too. Good show.
Keep going.
Woo, hot night, ain't it?
You want me to open the window, Miss Wellington?
No, the hell with the weather. Say, he's cute.
Reba, she didn't mean anything. She's just acting, that's all.
Well, anytime you're ready, Miss Wellington, we'll go up right to my room and start. I thought we'd read the play in my room.
All right, Day. I'm ready. When I see snakes, it's time to lay down.
Oh, but those are real, Miss Wellington. They're grandpas. Those are real. Miss Wellington, oh dear, I hope she's not going to... Miss Wellington!
And there she goes.
Well, she's out like a light.
You better let her sleep it off.
Reba! Miss Wellington just passed out.
Good!
Do you think she'll be all right?
Yes, but I wouldn't cast her in a religious play.
Well, I suppose I'll just have to wait.
Next time you meet an actress on the top of the bus, Penny, I think I send her the script instead of bringing her home to read it.
Ed, I wish you'd stop printing and take those love dreams around. You've got to get back in time to play for me when Kolinkov comes.
Kolinkov coming tonight?
Oh, yes. Tomorrow night's his night, but I had to change it on account of Alice.
Big doings around here tomorrow night,
isn't it exciting? You know, I'm so nervous. You'd think it was me he was engaged to instead of Alice.
What do you think they'll be like? His mother and father. Ed, what are you doing now?
Oh, Penny. Did you see the new mask I made last night? Guess who it is.
No, don't tell me, Ed. Let me guess. Helen of Troy.
No, actually, this is Mrs. Roosevelt.
You know what's cool about these Meccano sets? You can make just about anything with them. Last week, I made the Empire State Building.
What is it this week?
Oh, Queen Mary.
She hasn't got the right hat on.
Oh, Mr. DePina, would you go outside and see if there's somebody standing outside the house?
Why? What for?
Well, for the past 2 days when I've been out delivering candy, I think there's been a man following me.
Ed, you're crazy.
No, I'm not. He just stands and follows me and watches the house.
Really? I'll take a look.
I don't see why anybody would follow you for, Ed.
Well, there's a lot of kidnappings going on, Grandpa.
Yes, but not of Ed.
Well, did you check?
There's no one out there.
You sure?
Positive. I just saw him walk away.
What did you see?
Oh, it might have been anyone just walking along the street. Ed, will you hurry and get back?
Oh, all right.
Say, Mr. Sycamore, how about we finish those fireworks off in the basement?
Yeah, we're going to take the fireworks up to Mount Vernon in the morning. Come on.
Mother, may I borrow some paper? I'm making out a list for Reba tomorrow night.
Sure, dear. Here's some.
Why? What happened to your actress friend? Is she giving a performance?
Oh, no. She's not acting, Alice. She's really drunk.
Essie, dear, you're going to give Reba the kitchen all day tomorrow, aren't you? Because she'll need it.
Of course, Alice. I'm going to start some love dreams now, so I'll be way ahead.
Okay, thanks, dear. Listen, Mother, I'll be home at 3:00 tomorrow. You'll have everything down in the cellar by that time, right? By that, I mean the typewriter, the snakes, the printing press, and the xylophone.
And Miss Wellington.
And Miss Wellington. That'll give me enough time to arrange the table and fix the flowers.
Oh, the Kirbys are certainly going to get the wrong impression of this house.
You'll do all that, won't you, Mother?
Of course, dear.
And I think we'd better have cocktails ready by 7:15, just in case they happen to come a little early. I wonder if I ought to let Reba cook the dinner tomorrow night. What do you think, Grandpa?
Now, Alice, from what we've seen of the boy, I'm sure the Kirbys are nice people. And if everything isn't so elaborate tomorrow, it's all right, too.
Oh, darling, I'm not trying to impress them or pretend we're anything we aren't. I just want everything to go off well.
There's no reason why it shouldn't, Alice.
We're all going to do everything we can to make it a nice party.
Oh, my darlings, I love you so much. You're the most wonderful family in the world, and I'm the happiest girl in the world. I didn't know anyone could be this happy. Why, this past week has been, like, floating. He's so wonderful, Grandpa. Why, just seeing him, you didn't know what it does to me.
Just seeing him, huh? Just seeing him for lunch, seeing him for dinner, seeing him for 4 a.m., seeing him at 9:00 in the office, and there he is. Just seeing him.
I don't care. I'm in love. Mwah! Reba! Reba!
Isn't it nice seeing her so happy?
Oh, yes. I remember how it was when I was engaged to Paul. How happy I was. And you know I still feel that way.
I know. And it's also nice how Ed and Essie are getting along.
Oh, and Donald and Reba, too, even though they're not married. Do you suppose Mr. DePina will ever marry anyone, Grandpa?
Or there's Miss Wellington.
Woo! Oh, dear. I wish you'd wake up if you're going to have time enough to read the play.
Miss Wellington, look what I found, remember?
Why, yes, of course. It's my painting of you as the discus thrower. Look, Grandpa.
Oh, yes. I remember. Say, Mr. DePina, you got a little bit gray now, didn't you?
Is it noticeable?
Well, it was a long time ago, Grandpa, just before I stopped painting. Let's see, that's 8 years.
Ooh. So, why'd you never finish this, Miss Sycamore?
Well, I always meant to finish it, Mr. DePina, but one day I just started to write a play, and that was that. I never painted again.
Oh, good. I thought I was going to have to strip next.
My goodness. Who'd have thought the day I delivered ice, I would have stayed here for 8 years.
The milkman was here for 5, just before you.
Say, why'd he leave? I forget.
He didn't leave. He died.
He was such a nice man. Do you remember the funeral, Grandpa? We didn't know his name, and it was so hard to get a certificate.
What was the name we gave him?
Martin Vanderhoff. We gave him your name.
Right.
It really was a wonderful idea. Otherwise, he never would have gotten all those flowers.
And it wasn't that either. I mean, I haven't had a real telephone call or mail ever since.
Yes, it really was a wonderful idea.
You know, Miss Sycamore, it's a shame you never finished this painting. I kind of like to have it.
You know what, Mr. DePina? I think I'll do some work on it right tonight.
Say, will ya?
I don't think she's gonna wake up anyhow. Look, Mr. DePina, why don't you go down to the cellar and put on your costume? And, oh, bring up the easel. Is it still down there?
I think so.
Where did I put my paints and brushes?
Oh, Rabishka! My little Rabishka!
Yes, Mr. Kolenkov!
Oh, hello, Mr. Kolenkov. Essie's in the kitchen.
Miss Sycamore, I greet you. Grandpa, what should I do with my little Rabishka here? I keep telling her she would make a great toll dancer. But she only laughs.
No, sir, I couldn't get up on my toes, Mr. Kolenkov. I've got corns.
Rabishka, you can wear diamonds.
She is a great girl, Grandpa.
Yes.
What is that?
It's a painting of Mr. DePina. Penny drew it.
It stinks.
What do you think of that?
What is that?
It's a friend of Miss Sycamore's.
She is drunk, no?
She is drunk, yes. So how you been, Colin Carr?
Magnificent! Life is chasing all around inside of me, like a squirrel!
Tis her. So, what's new in Russia? How's your friend in Moscow?
I have just heard from him. I say for you the step.
Thank you, Colin Carr.
They had sent him to Siberia.
Ooh. How he's liking that?
He has escaped! He has escaped and gone back to Moscow. He will get them. They do not get him. Oh, the Soviet government! I can take on the whole Soviet government and just... Oh.
Sorry I'm late, Mr. Kolenkov. I'll get into my dancing clothes right away.
Tonight, my Pavlo, we are ready to work. Tonight, we will try something new.
So, how's Essie doing?
Confidently, she stinks.
Well, as long as she's having fun.
You sure do tickle Reba, Mr. Kolenkov. She's laughing her head off out there.
She is a great woman, Donald. Donald, what do you think about the Soviet government?
The what, Mr. Kolenkov?
I withdraw the question. What do you think about this government?
Oh, I like it fine. I'm on relief, you know?
Oh, yes. Don't you like it?
Yeah, sir. It's fine. Only thing is, you gotta go around to the place every week to get it. And sometimes, you gotta stand in line pretty near half an hour. The government ought to be run better than that, don't you think, Grandpa?
The government ought to stop sending me these letters. They want me to be down at the United States Marshal's office 10 a.m. Tuesday morning.
Oh, income tax. They have got you, Grandpa.
They got me as to keep Donald on relief.
You don't say, Grandpa. You going to pay from now on?
That's what they want me to do.
You mean I come around here and get it instead of sending that line?
No, Donald. I'm afraid you're still going to waste a full half an hour of your day.
Well, I don't like it. Breaks up my week.
He should have been in Russia when the revolution came. Then he would have stood in line. A bread line. Oh, Grandpa, what have they done with Russia? Think of it. The Grand Duchess Olga Katrina, a cousin of the Tsar. She is a waitress in Child Restaurant. I ordered baked beans from her only yesterday. It broke my heart. A crazy world, Grandpa.
The world's not so crazy, Kolenkov. It's the people in it.
How can you relax at a time like this?
Well, there wouldn't be times like these if people just relax. You know, life is pretty simple if you just let it get to you. People forget that. I know I did. I was right in the thick of it. I was fighting, scratching and clawing. Regular jungle. And one day it just struck me that I wasn't having any fun.
So you did what?
Relaxed. 35 years and I've been a happier man ever since.
Oh, good evening, Mr. Colin.
Miss Alice, I now present to you my congratulations.
Thank you.
May you be very happy and have many children. Oh. That is my prayers for you.
Why, that's quite a thought.
Ah, love. Love is all that's left in the world, Grandpa.
Yes, but there's plenty of that.
And soon Stalin will take that away too, I tell you, Grandpa.
It seems so nice to get in to buy art things again. They still look all right, don't they, Grandpa?
Yes.
You are the Buff of Paris, Madame Sycamore.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Kolenkov.
I didn't know you was working for the WPA.
Oh, no, Donald. You see, I used to paint all the time before, but...
It happened again. There was a fellow following me every place I went.
Nonsense, Ed. It's your imagination.
No, it isn't. It happens every time when I go out to deliver candy.
Well, maybe he wants a piece of your candy.
Well, it's all right for you to laugh, Grandpa, but you're not the one being followed out there.
You do not know what following is. In Russia, everybody was followed. I was followed right out of Russia.
You see, Ed? All imagination.
Well, maybe.
Say, Mr. Sycamore, where do you want this?
Right here, Mr. Dupina.
Oh.
Say, Mr. Dupina, has your figure changed after these years?
No.
Ed, tonight's lesson, we'll use the first movement of Scheherazade.
Okay.
Mr. Dupina, would you mind sucking in your stomach? Yes, Miss Wellington? Yes? Woo! Oh, dear.
Sorry, Mr. Kolenkov. I couldn't find my slippers.
You have a hot night foot, my Pavlov. But art is only achieved through perspiration.
Why, that's wonderful, Mr. Kolenkov. Did you hear that, Grandpa? Art is only achieved through perspiration.
Yes, but it helps if you got a little bit of talent with it. Only made 2 bullseyes last night. Gotta do better than that.
Are we ready? We begin! Now, pirouette! Pirouette! Come, come, you can do that now. 8 years! Ha! At last! Entrant! Entrant! No, Grandpa, you cannot relax with Stalin's in Russia. The Tsar relaxed, and what happened to him was too late.
Mr. Kolenkov! Mr. Kolenkov!
Had he not relaxed, the Grand Duchess Olga Katrina would not be signing big feet today.
Mr. Kolenkov!
You will forgive me. We go back to the pirouette.
Would you mind sucking in your stomach, Mr. Dupina?
A little freer. A little freer with the hands. The body must work. And help with the music! The music must be free too!
Miss Sycamore! Miss Sycamore! Miss Sycamore!
Good evening!
How do you do?
I hope we're not too early.
Oh, no, it's all right. We're glad to see you.
Why? Yes. Well, we thought it was to be tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night?
What? No, it's all right. Just come on in and make yourselves comfortable.
Tony, how'd you have done such a thing?
I don't know. I thought it was...
Really, Tony? This is most embarrassing.
No, it's all right. We weren't doing anything at all.
Oh, no. Just a quiet evening at home.
That's all. This is Alice's mother, Miss Sycamore.
How do you do?
Alice's sister, Mrs. Carmichael. Mr. Carmichael, and Mr. Kolenkov. And, Mr. Dupina.
How do you do?
Don't mind me. I'll just take my costume right off.
Mr. Dupina.
Oh,
you, Mr. Dabina, do you mind telling Mr. Sycamore to come downstairs? The Kirbys are here.
Oh, and be sure to put his pants on.
All right. Excuse me.
Thank you. I'll tell Alice that you're... Alice, dear!
What is it, Mother?
Would you come down for a minute, dear? We have a surprise for you. Oh. Well...
May I take your wrap, Mrs. Kirby?
Well, thank you. If you're perfectly sure that we're not...
Oh, don't be alarmed, Mrs. Kirby. They're perfectly harmless.
Thank you.
Take them to the kitchen, Ed.
Of course, we're so used to having them around the house. I'm sorry to trouble you, but snakes happen to be.
I'm sorry. I feel very uncomfortable about this. Tony, how could you have done such a thing?
I'm sorry, Father. I thought it was tonight.
It was very careless of you. Very.
Oh, no, Mr. Kirby. Anybody can get mixed up.
Now, Penny, how about you go get some dinner for these folks? They did come to eat, you know.
Oh, please don't bother. We're really not hungry at all.
Oh, but it's not a bit of bother. Ed, tell Donald to run down to the A&P and get half a dozen bottles of beer and some canned salmon. Do you like canned salmon, Mr. Kirby?
Oh, please don't bother, Mr. Kumar. I suffer from a case of indigestion.
Oh, I'm sorry. How about you, Mrs. Kirby? Do you like canned salmon?
Oh, I'm very fond of it.
You can have Frankfurters if you'd rather.
Either one will do.
Oh, better make it Frankfurters and some canned corn and Campbell soup. Got that, Ed?
Okay.
Tell them to hurry! The A&P is just at the corner and Frankfurters don't take any time to boil.
Oh, and there's Alice's father, Mr. Sycamore, Mr. and Mrs. Kirby.
How do you do?
Hope you forgive my appearance.
Oh, this is Mr. Sycamore's busiest time of the year. Just before the 4th of July, he always...
Darling, I'm the most dull-witted person in the world. I thought it was tonight.
Oh, why, Tony, I thought you... I'm so sorry, I can't imagine why I wasn't... Have you all met each other?
Yes, indeed.
How do you do, Alice? Oh, how do you do, Mrs. Kirby? I'm afraid I'm not very presentable. Oh,
darling, you look lovely.
Of course she does. And don't let this get to you, my dear. We've all just met a night sooner, that's all.
Yes, but I was planning such a nice party tomorrow night.
Well, we're coming in tomorrow then, too.
There you are, Alice. Am I forgiven?
I guess so. It's just that I... We'd better see about getting you guys some dinner.
Oh, that's all been taken care of, Alice. That's all been attended to.
But, Mother, what did you send out for? Because Mr. Kirby suffers from indigestion. He can only eat certain things.
Oh, it's all right. It's all right.
Of course it is, darling.
I asked him what he wanted, Alice.
Oh, yes, but...
Please don't make a big deal out of it. Just because a little indigestion.
Perhaps, Mr. Kirby, you're not indigestion at all. Perhaps you have stomach ulcers.
Don't be absurd, Mr. Kolenkov.
You mustn't mind Kolenkov, Mr. Kirby. He's Russian, and Russians are inclined to look on the dark side.
All right, I am Russian, but a friend of mine, a Russian, died from stomach ulcers.
Please, Mr. Kolenkov, Mr. Kirby has indigestion, and that's all.
All right, let him wait.
Do sit down, Mr. Kirby. Make yourself comfortable.
Yes, thank you.
Well.
So, how do you find business conditions? Are we well out of the depression?
What? Ah, yes, I think so. Of course, it all depends.
Do you suppose that we'll keep on improving?
Broadly speaking, yes. As a matter of fact, factory production is now up 64% full capacity as compared to 82% in 1925. Now, in 1929...
There was a young lady from Wheeling who had remarkable feeling.
She's not quite accountable for her actions. She's a friend of Miss Sycamore's.
She came over for dinner and was overcome by the heat.
Oh, yes, of course. You know, some people feel it more than others. Perhaps I'd better check up on her. Excuse me.
It is awfully hot. You usually escape all this hot weather, Mrs. Kirby, don't you, up in Maine?
As a rule, I had to come down this week, however, for the flower show.
Mother wouldn't miss that show for the world. That blue ribbon is a high spot of her year.
I won a ribbon at a flower show once for raising onions. Remember, Alice?
Oh, that was a garden show, Essie.
Oh. I think she'll be all right. Has Donald come back yet?
Oh, no, he hasn't.
Well, he'll be back any time, and dinner won't be any time at all now. I am afraid he must be starved.
Oh, it's quite all right. Hello. What's this? I didn't know there were little children in this house.
Oh, no, that's mine, you see. It's mine.
Oh, I suppose every man has his hobby. Or do you use it as a model of some kind?
No, I just play with it.
Maybe you'd be better off, Father, if you had a hobby like that, instead of raising orchids.
Yes, I wouldn't be surprised.
Oh, do tell us about your orchids, Mr. Kirby. You know they take 6 years before they blossom. Think of that.
Some take longer than that. I have a bulb coming on that I've waited 10 years for.
Well, you know, believe it or not, I was waiting for an orchid.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, of course. During this time, they require the most scrupulous care. I remember one bulb I was very fond of.
Oh, thank goodness. Did you get everything, Donald?
Yes, only they didn't have frankfurters, so I got pickled pig's feet.
Never mind, Donald. Just ping everything into the kitchen. And Mr. Kirby, do tell them all about your orchids. I'm sure they'd love to hear it. Excuse me.
Kind of an expensive hobby, isn't it, Mr. Kirby? Raising orchids?
Yes, but I believe if a hobby brings one sufficient enough pleasure, it is never expensive.
That's very true.
You see, I need something to relieve the daily nerve strain. Why? After a week in Wall Street, I'd go crazy. If I didn't have something like that, well, lots of men I know own yachts for that very same reason.
Why don't you quit Wall Street?
How's that?
I was just joking.
Of course.
I think it's necessary for everyone to have a hobby, of course. To me, it's more than just a hobby, but my great solace is spiritualism.
Spiritualism? Now, Mrs. Kirby, everyone knows that's a fake.
To me, Miss Sycamore, spiritualism is... well... I'd rather not discuss it, Miss Sycamore.
Now, Penny, don't you have one or two of your own hobbies?
Yes, but not silly ones.
I don't think it matters what the hobby is. The important thing is to have one.
To be ideal, a hobby should improve the body as well as the mind. The Romans were great people. Why? What was their hobby? Wrestling! In wrestling, you have to think quick with the mind and act quick with the body.
I don't think wrestling is very practical for most of us. I wouldn't make a very good showing as a wrestler.
You could be a great wrestler. You're built for it. Look!
Kirby, are you hurt?
Are you okay, Father?
Oh, my glasses. Where are my glasses?
Oh, here they are, Mr. Kirby. Oh, Mr. Kirby, they're broken.
Oh, I am sorry, but when you wrestle again, Mr. Kirby, you will, of course, not wear glasses.
I do not intend on risking again, Mr. Kolenkov.
Better sit down, Father.
Oh, Mr. Kolenkov, how could you do such a thing? Why didn't somebody stop him?
I think if you don't mind, perhaps we had better be going.
Mother!
Oh, Mrs. Kirby, please. Mr. Kirby, please don't go. I've ordered some scrambled eggs and plain salad. Oh, please don't go.
I apologize if I did anything wrong, and I'm sorry.
I can't tell you how sorry I am, Mr. Kirby, if I'd have been there.
It's quite all right.
Of course it's all right. We're not going.
Well, that was exciting for a moment now, wasn't it?
You were talking about your orchids, Mr. Kirby. Do you have varieties?
I'm afraid I've forgotten all about my orchids.
Oh, I'm awfully sorry, Mr. Kirby.
What did I do to Sora? I threw him on the ground! Did it kill him?
Please, Mr. Colin Cobb. I'm sure dinner will be any time at all now.
Would you like a candy while you're waiting, Mr. Kirby? I've got some freshly made.
Oh, my doctor does not permit me to eat candy, thank you.
Oh, but these are nothing. They're just coconut and marshmallow and fudge.
Effie, don't.
Miss Alice.
Oh, excuse me. What is this?
Miss Alice, the eggplant fell down the sink.
Oh, make some more, quick.
I ain't got any.
Oh, send Donald out for some.
Okay.
Tell him to hurry. I'm so sorry. There'll be a little delay, but everything will be ready in just a minute.
I've certainly put you people through a lot with my stupidity.
Not at all, Tony.
Well, look! Why don't we all play a game of some sort while we're waiting?
Oh, that'd be fine.
Well, Mother, I don't think Mr. Kirby...
I have an idea. I know a wonderful trick involving a glass of water.
But I'm sure Mr. and Mrs. Kirby would love this game. It's perfectly harmless.
I'm not very good at games, Miss Sycamore.
Oh, but any fool could play this game, Mr. Kirby. All you have to do is write your name on a piece of paper.
Mother, Mr. Kirby doesn't want to...
Oh, he'll love it.
Well...
Here you are, Mr. Kirby. Write your name on this piece of paper. And, Mrs. Kirby, you do the same on this one.
Mother, what is this game?
It's called Forget Me Not. I used to play it at school. Oh, here you are, Grandpa. Now, I'm going to call out 5 words, just... anything at all. And as I say each word, you're to put down the first thing that comes into your mind. Is that clear? For instance, if I say grass, you might put down green, just whatever you think of, see? Or if I call out chair, you might put down table. It shows the reactions people have to different things. You see how simple it is, Mr. Kirby?
Come on, Father, be a sport.
Very well, I shall be happy to play.
You see, Alice? He does want to play.
Well,
now then, are we ready?
Ready!
Now remember, you must play fair. Put down the first thing that comes into your mind.
I understand.
Is everybody ready? The first word is potatoes. Potatoes. Ready for the next one? Bathroom.
Mother.
Bathroom. Got that?
Go ahead.
Lust.
Mother, that's not exactly what you...
Nonsense, Alice. That word's all right.
Mother, it's not all right.
Oh, I don't know. It seems to me it's a perfectly fair word.
You see? Now you mustn't interrupt the game.
What was that last word again?
Lust, Mr. Kirby.
I've got it. This is quite a game now, isn't
it? Oh, Grandpa. Okay, the next word is honeymoon. Now, Essie. Okay, the last word is sex.
Mother!
Everybody got sex? All right, now give me all of your papers. May I have your paper, Mr. Kirby?
Well, what happens now?
Oh, now's the best part. Now I get to read out your reactions.
That's quite an interesting game, Mr. Kirby.
I knew you'd like it. I'll read your paper first, Mr. Kirby. Is everybody ready? This is Mr. Kirby. Potatoes, steak. Oh, that's very good. You see how they go together? Steak and potatoes.
Thank you. I just happened to think of it.
It's very good. Bathroom, toothpaste. Well, lust, unlawful. Isn't that nice? Honeymoon, trip. Yes, and sex. Mail.
Oh!
That's really a wonderful paper, Mr. Kirby.
Thank you. I just happened to think of it. You know, this isn't just a game. It's more of an experiment in psychology, isn't it?
Oh, yes, it is. It's just how your mind works. Now we'll see how Mrs. Kirby's mind works. Is everybody ready? This is Mrs. Kirby. Potatoes. Starch. Oh, I know just what you mean, Mrs. Kirby. Oh, dear. Bathroom, Mr. Kirby.
What was that?
Bathroom, Mr. Kirby.
I don't quite follow you, my dear.
I don't know. I just thought of you and connect. She was it. After all, you are in there a good deal, Anthony. Bathing and shaving. Well, you do take a long time.
Indeed, I didn't realize I was being selfish in the matter. Will you go on, Miss Sycamore?
Oh, no, I think it's a very silly game and we ought to stop.
Yes.
No, no. Carry on, Miss Sycamore.
Where was I? Lust. Human.
Human? Really, Miriam?
I just meant, Anthony, that lust is, after all, a human emotion.
It is not a human emotion. It's depraved.
Very well, Anthony. I'm wrong.
No, really, it's the most pointless game. Suppose we play 20 questions.
Yes.
No, no, no. Will you go on, Miss Sycamore? What was the next word?
Honeymoon?
Ah, honeymoon. And what was Mrs. Kirby's answer?
Ah. Honeymoon. Dull.
Did you say dull?
What I meant, Anthony, was that Hot Springs wasn't very gay that season. All those old people sitting on the porch all afternoon and nothing to do at night.
That was not your reaction at last, I recall it. Father, it's only a game.
A very illuminating game.
Will you go on, Miss Sycamore?
Oh, this one's all right, Mr. Kirby. Sex. Wall Street.
Wall Street? What do you mean by that, Miriam?
I don't know what I meant, Anthony. Nothing.
But you must have meant something, or else you wouldn't have put it down.
It was just the first thing that came into my head. That's all.
But what does it mean, sex, Wall Street?
Oh, I don't know what it means, Anthony. It's just that you're always talking about Wall Street, even when we're in the middle of... I don't know what I meant. Would you mind terribly, Alice, if we... didn't stay for dinner. I'm afraid this game has given me a headache.
Oh, I understand, Mrs. Kirby.
Perhaps we have this dinner another night.
But you're coming tomorrow night, aren't you?
I'm afraid we have an engagement tomorrow night.
Perhaps we postpone this whole affair for a while. Hot weather and...
I think we're being very ungracious. Of course we'll stay to dinner tonight.
But, Tony, I have a very bad headache.
Come, Tony. I'm sure everyone understands.
Well, I don't! I think we ought to stay.
No, Tony.
What?
We were fools to ever think this would work. It won't. Mr. Kirby, I won't be in at the office tomorrow. In fact, I won't be in at all anymore.
Alice, what are you talking about?
It's quite all right. I'm very sorry. Are you ready, Miriam?
Yes, Anthony.
And darling, you mustn't mind this.
Well, it has been nice. So I've met you all.
Yes, lovely.
Are you coming, Tony?
No, Father. Not.
Very well. Your mother and I will be waiting for you at home. Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Stay there where you are, everyone! Don't move.
How dare you? What's the meaning of this?
What is all of this?
I demand an
explanation. Keep your mouth shut, you! Which one is it?
This is it.
Hey, what are you doing?
Fred! My baby! Hippo, what is it?
This is an outrage!
Shut up! What's your name?
Edward Carmichael. I haven't done anything.
You haven't?
This seems rather high-handed to me. What's the meaning of all of this?
Department of Justice!
Oh my goodness, J-Men! What have you done?
I haven't done anything.
What's the boy done, officer?
That door to the cellar?
Yes. No.
Yes.
Mac? Jim?
Yes, sir.
Take a look upstairs, see what you find.
But I haven't done anything.
You haven't, huh? Come here, you.
Ever seen these before?
Oh, they're my circulars.
You print this stuff, huh?
Oh, yes, sir.
And you put it in boxes of candy. Get them into people's homes?
Oh, the love trees.
But I didn't mean anything.
You didn't, huh? Dynamite the Capitol. Dynamite the White House. Dynamite the Supreme Court. God is the state. The state is God.
But I didn't mean any of that. I mean, come on. I just like to print stuff, don't I, Grandpa?
No, officer. The government's in no real danger of Ed. Printing is just his hobby. He prints anything.
He does, man.
I never heard of such nonsense.
I refuse to stay.
Ed, let me get my pipe.
Well, shut up, you. You were right, Chief. They've got enough gunpowder down there to blow up the whole city.
But we only use that.
Keep still. Everyone in this house is under arrest.
No, officer, you this is all nonsense.
You have to go down there. I left the pipe.
Shut up, all of you.
It seems to me.
Shut up.
Good heavens.
Keep still, you. Stop that. Stop it.
Oh, who's that? Oh, that's my mother.
Fireworks.
The fireworks.
In the West Side of Court this morning, after spending the night in jail, the defendants, 13 in all, were brought before Judge Callahan and given suspended sentences for manufacturing fireworks without a permit.
Kept me in the same cell with the strip teaser from a burlesque show.
I was in the cell with Mr. Kirby. My, he was mad.
Mrs. Kirby and the strip teaser, they were fighting all night long.
Whole lot about Mr. Kirby here. Anthony W. Kirby, head of Kirby & Co., 62 Wall Street, who was among those apprehended, declared he was in no way interested in the manufacture of fireworks, but refused to state why he was on the premises at the time of the raid. Mr. Kirby is a member of the Union Club, the Racquet Club, the Harvard Club, and the National Geographic Society. My, he certainly is a joiner.
All them rich men are elks or something.
I suppose after all this, Mr. Tony ain't ever gonna marry Miss Silas, huh?
No, sir, and that's too bad, because Miss Silas sure does love that boy. And I don't know what I'm gonna do with all that food out in the kitchen. Ain't gonna be no party tonight, that's for sure.
Ain't we gonna eat it anyhow?
Well, I'm cooking it, but I don't think anybody gonna have an appetite.
Well, I'm hungry.
Well, they ain't. They all so broke up about Miss Alice.
That's too bad, ain't it?
Sure is.
Not even a balloon left.
Hello, Mrs. DePina. How's your hand? Better?
Yeah, it's better. Say, is there more olive oil over there?
It's in the salad bowl.
All right.
Well, she's going. Nothing anybody said could change her.
She won't be away for long now, will she, Miss Sycamore?
I don't know, Reba. She won't say.
She's gonna be lonesome around here without her.
How you feel, Miss Sycamore?
Oh, I'm all right, Donald. Just a little upset. Perhaps if I do some of my work, I'll feel better.
I won't bother you then, Miss Sycamore.
She's going, Penny.
Yes.
Penny.
I just can't help it, Paul. Somehow I feel like it's our fault.
It's my fault more than yours, Penny. All this time I've just been going along, enjoying myself. Maybe I should have been thinking more about Alice.
Don't say that, Paul. You've been a wonderful father and husband, too.
No, I haven't. Maybe if I'd gone ahead and been an architect. I don't know. Something Alice could be proud of. I thought that all last night looking at Mr. Kirby.
But we've been so happy, Paul.
I know, but maybe that's not enough. I used to think it was, but I'm kind of mixed up now.
What time is she leaving?
Pretty soon. Train leaves 7:30.
Oh, if only she talked to Tony. I'm sure he could persuade her.
It won't help. He's been trying to all day.
Well, where is he now?
don't know. Suppose he's walking around the block again. Anyhow, she won't talk to him.
Well, maybe Tony can catch her as she's leaving.
It won't help, Penny.
No. No, I don't suppose. And I feel so sorry for Tony, too. Well, Grandpa?
No, Penny, let the girl alone.
But Grandpa!
Suppose she goes to the Adirondacks. You get just enough Adirondacks and then you come home.
But it's also terrible, Grandpa.
Yes, but it has a bright side, too.
How do you mean?
Mr. Kirby getting into the patrol wagon for once. And the expression on his face when him and Donald had a bathe together. I'm not going to forget that, even if I live to be 100. And I intend to. If I could have things like that going on.
Oh, it was even worse with Mrs. Kirby. When the matron stripped her, there was a burlesque dancer, and she kept singing a strip song while Mrs. Kirby undressed.
I'm telling you, Bar Harbor is going to sound pretty dull to the Kirbys this summer. Need any help?
No, thanks, Grandpa. I'm just going to press these.
No, Penny.
I'll bring the big bag down as soon as you're ready, Alice.
Thanks, Ed. Do you want to take some candy along for the train, Alice?
No, thanks, Hessie. Really, Alice, you could be just as alone here as you could in the mountains. You could stay in your room the whole time.
No, Mother. I want to be alone, away from everybody. I love you all, you know that, but I just need to get away for a while. I'll be all right. Father, did you phone for a cab?
No, I didn't know you wanted one.
Oh, I told Mr. DePina to tell you, Paul. Didn't he tell you?
He told me, but I forget.
Oh, I wish I lived in a family that didn't always forget everything, that behaved the way other people's families do. I'm so sick of cornflakes and Donald and everything. Why can't we be like normal people? Roast beef, two green vegetables, and doilies on the table. A place you can bring your friends to without...
I'll see if I can do anything. Tony, talk to her. She's in the kitchen.
Thanks. Alice, won't you listen to me, please?
Tony, no.
Alice, not being fair. At least let me talk to you.
No. Where'd they go?
They went upstairs.
She walked right out the minute he came in.
Knocked the olive oil right out of my hand. Can smell our fishy now.
How are you doing, Mr. DePina? I'm still hurting you.
No, it's better.
Everything burned down there, huh?
Everything. Even my Roman costume, too.
I told you there was a bright side to everything. Everything besides those 23 years back of income tax. I get a new letter every day.
Say, Grandpa, what are you gonna do about that?
I had a plan, but it's not going to work. But I'm going to try it anyhow.
What is it?
Good evening, everybody.
Why, Mr. Colton call?
Forgive me, the door was open.
Come on in.
You'll forgive my coming in today. I realize you all are upset.
That's all right, Mr. Colton call.
I don't think I can take a lesson today, Mr. Kolenkov. I don't feel up to it.
Well, I, good.
But do stay to dinner, Mr. Kolenkov. We have all that food and somebody's got
to
eat it.
I'll be happy to, Madam Sycamore.
Fine.
Thank you. Now, I wonder if I know you well enough to ask of you of a great favor.
Why, of course, Mr. Kolenkov.
You have all heard me talk about my friend, the Grand Duchess Olga Katrina.
Yes?
Right. She is a great woman, the Grand Duchess. She was the cousin of Tsar of Russia. And today she is waitress in Child's Restaurant Times Square.
Well, if there's anything at all we can do, Mr. Kolenkov.
I tell you, the Grand Duchess Olga Katrina has not had a good meal since before the revolution.
She must be very hungry.
And not only is her day off, Thursday, but it's also the anniversary of Peter the Great, a remarkable man.
Mr. Kolenkov. If you mean to say that the Grand Duchess would come here for dinner, why, we'd be honored.
Oh, yes.
In the name of the Grand Duchess, I thank you.
Oh, I'm so excited to meet her. Where is she?
She's outside in the street, waiting. I'll bring her in.
And your tie. I see your dress. How do I look? All right?
The Grand Duchess Olga Katrina. Your Highness, allow me to present to you Madam Sycamore, Madam Carmichael. Grandpa.
Madame.
Mr. Carmichael, Mr. Sycamore, and Mr. DePenna.
Now, Mr. DePenna.
Do you have a seat, Your Highness?
Thank you. You are most kind.
We are honored to receive you, Your Highness.
I am most happy to be here. How soon is dinner?
Quite soon, Your Highness. Very soon.
Good. I do not mean to be rude, but I must be at the restaurant at 8 o'clock. I am substituting for another waitress.
I'll make sure to bring you back on time, Your Highness.
Thank you. Oh.
Say, Duchess, didn't you wait on me once in 72nd Street Place?
No. That was my sister.
The Grand Duchess Natasha.
I work in Times Square.
Quite a lot of your folks down here, isn't there?
Oh, yes. Many. My uncle, the Grand Duke Sergei, he is an elevator man at Macy's. A very nice man. Then there is my cousin, Prince Alexis. He will not speak to the rest of us because he works at Hartig Carnegie. He is in ladies' underwear.
He is willing to talk to you when you're selling hot dogs at Coney Island.
Ah, Kulinkov. Our time is coming. My sister, Natasha, is starting to be a manicurist. Uncle Sergei, they have promised to make floor walker. And next month, I get transferred to the Fifth Avenue Childs.
Ooh.
From there, it is only a step to straps. And then we will see what Prince Alexei says.
I'm sure you've got him.
You are telling me?
Your Highness, did you know the Tsar, personally, I mean?
Of course. He was my cousin. It was terrible what happened to him, but perhaps it was for the best. Where could he get a job now?
Rolfa, this is true.
And poor relations are poor relations. It is the same in every family. My cousin, the King of Sweden, he was very nice to us for about 10 years. Every once in a while, he would send in a money order. And then he said, I just cannot go on. I am not doing so well myself. I do not blame him.
Oh, no, of course not. Would you excuse me for a moment?
Grand Duchess, is it true what they say about Rasputin?
Oh, everyone wants to know about Rasputin. Yes, my dear. It is true. And how?
You don't say.
Your Highness, you must be careful and watch the time.
Yes, I must not be late. The manager does not like me. He is a communist.
We'll be sure to hurry things up. Essie, why don't you go in and help Reba in the kitchen?
I will help you. I'm a very good cook.
But Your Highness, not on your day off.
I do not mind. Where is your kitchen?
Oh, right through here. But you're the guest of honor, Your Highness.
But I love to cook. Come, Kulinkov, if they have got sour cream and pop cheese, I will make you some blintzes.
Ah, blintzes. Come, my Pavlova. We will show you something.
Say, the Duchess is all right, isn't she? Hey, Duchess, can I help?
Gee, she's got a wonderful face for a mask.
She's a very nice woman, considering she's a Grand Duchess.
Isn't it wonderful how they go through enough and still manage to keep kind of gay, too?
She made me forget about everything for a moment.
I suppose I'll go call that cab.
Oh, no, wait, Paul, here they are. Maybe Tony is. Ed, will you go up and bring my bags down?
Don't do it, Ed.
Ed, please.
All right, Ed. Bring him down. You know you have the summoner's daughter in all 48 states?
That must be the cab.
If it is, it's certainly wonderful service.
Tony for Alice?
Yes. Yes, he is. Come in, Mr. Kirby.
How do you do?
Good evening.
Good evening.
I want you to come home with me. Your mother is very upset.
Very well, Father. Goodbye, Alice.
Bye, Tony.
I need not say how difficult this is for Mrs. Kirby and myself, but I'm sure you understand.
Yes. And in a way, no. Now, Mr. Kirby, you got to understand. These two young people don't got as much sense as you and I.
Grandpa, will you please...
Now, Alice, I'm talking to Mr. Kirby. A cat can look at a king, can't he?
Do you want me to do that for you, Alice?
No, thanks, Mother.
You know, you got quite a while before the train leaves, Alice.
Will you send a cab to 761 Claremont Street right away, please? Yes, that's right. Thank you.
Alice.
Father.
Are you ready, Tony?
Now, Mr. Kirby, I'm sure after last night, you think this family is somewhat crazy.
No, I wouldn't say that. Although I'm not going out to dinner and spending the night in
jail.
Well,
you got to remember, you did come on the wrong night. Oh, Mr. Kirby, I can guarantee that if you stay tonight, nothing will happen. Maybe.
It was not merely last night that convinced Mrs. Kirby and myself that this engagement would be unwise.
Father, I can handle my own affairs. Now, Alice, for the last time, will you marry me?
No, Tony, it's no use. Your father's right.
No, he's not.
No, Alice, you're in love with this boy, and you're not marrying him because we're the type of people we are.
Grandpa.
No, Alice, I know you think the two families might not get along. Maybe we wouldn't, but who says that they're right and we're wrong?
Grandpa, I didn't say that. I only feel
what I feel is that Tony is too nice of a boy to wake up 20 years from now with nothing but stocks and bonds in his life.
How's that?
Mixed up and unhappy, the way you are.
I beg your pardon, Mr. Vanderhoff. I'm a very happy man.
Are you?
Yes, indeed I am.
I don't think so. Where do you suppose your indigestion comes from? Happiness? No. You get it because you're stuck doing things you don't want to do.
I don't do anything I don't want to do.
Yes, you do. You said last night that by the end of the week in Wall Street, you're pretty much near crazy. Why do you do this to yourself?
Never I do it, why? Well, that's my business. A man can't give up his business.
Why not? You got all the money you need. You can't take it with you.
That's a very easy you to say, but I've spent my entire life setting up my business.
And what's it got you? Same kind of mail every morning, same kind of deal, same kind of dinner, same indigestion. Where does the fun come in, Mr. Kirby? You ought to want something more than when you started off. We ain't got too much time, you know. Any of us.
Well, what do you expect me to do? Live the way you do? Do nothing?
Well, I have a lot of fun. I have time to do anything. I have time to read, talk, visit the zoo now and then, practice my darts. I even have time to notice when spring comes around. I don't talk to anybody. I don't want to. I don't have 6 hours of things I have to do every day before I get 1 hour of what I like in. And I haven't drank a bicarbonate of soda in 35 years. What's the matter with that?
The matter with that? Why? Suppose we all did that. A fine world. Ridiculous. Who would get the work done?
There's always people who like to work. You can't stop them. Inventions, and they fly the ocean. There's also people to go down to Wall Street, too, because they like it. But from what I've seen of you, I don't think you're one of them. I think you're missing something.
I'm not aware that I'm missing anything.
I wasn't either till I quit. I used to get down to that office 9 o'clock sharp, no matter how I felt. Lay awake nights in fear that I wouldn't get that contract. I used to worry about the world, too. I got all worked up whether Cleveland or Blaine was going to be elected president. It was awful important back then, but who cares now? What I'm trying to say, Mr. Kirby, is that I've had 35 years of my life that nobody could take back from me, no matter what they do to the world. See?
Yes, I do see. Very dangerous philosophy, Mr. Vanderhoff. It's un-American, and it's exactly why I oppose this marriage.
What's the matter with it, Father?
The matter with what? Might sound like communism, that's what it is.
You didn't always think so.
I most certainly did. What are you talking about?
I'll tell you what I'm talking about, because there was a time in your life when you wanted to be a trapeze artist.
What? Why, Tony, don't be an idiot.
Oh, yes, I read those letters you wrote to Grandfather. Remember those?
No. How dare you? How dare you?
Why, isn't that wonderful? Did you wear tights, Mr. Kirby?
I certainly did not. was 14 years old at the time. The whole thing's absurd.
Yes, but at 18, you wanted to be a saxophone player, didn't you? And at 21, you ran away from home because grandfather wanted you to go into the business. It's all down there in black and white. You didn't always think so.
Well, well, well.
I may have had silly notions in my youth. Thank God my father not forgot me. I went into the business and forgot all about them.
Not altogether, father. There's still a saxophone in the back of his clothes closet.
There is.
That's enough. We'll discuss this later.
No! I want to talk about it now. I think Mr. Vanderhoff was right. Dead right. I'm never going back to that office. I've always hated it, and I'm not going on with it. And I'll tell you something else. I didn't make a mistake last night. I knew it was the wrong night. I brought you here on purpose.
For Tony's sake.
Because I wanted you to wake up. I wanted you to see a real family as they really were. A family that loved and understood each other. You don't understand me. You never had time. Well, I'm not making the same mistake you made. I'm clearing out.
What do you mean?
I mean, I'm not going to be pushed into the business just because I'm your son. I'm getting out while there's still time.
But Tony, what will you do?
I don't know. Maybe I'll be a bricklayer or something. But at least I'll be doing something I want to do.
Then let's see the cab.
Tell him to wait a minute, Ed.
Grandpa.
Do you mind, Alice? Now, Mr. Kirby, I'm sure Tony is going through what both you and I went through when we were his age. We all did it, and we were right. You know, how many of us would be willing to settle when we're young for something we'd eventually get? All those plans we make, what happens to them? You know, Mr. Kirby, it's only a handful of the lucky ones that can even look back and say they came close. Mr. Kirby, before they clean out that closet, I suggest you put in a good few hours into that saxophone.
I beg your pardon, but before I make the blessings, how many would there be to dinner?
Your Highness, may I introduce to you Mr. Anthony Kirby and Mr. Kirby Jr., the Grand Duchess Olga Katrina.
How's that?
How do you do? Before I make the blessings, how many would there be to dinner?
Oh, I make quite a stack of them. You can't ever tell.
Good. The Tsar always said to me, Olga, do not be stingy with the blessings.
Who do you say that was?
The Grand Duchess, Olga Katrina. She's cooking the dinner.
Oh.
And speaking of dinner, why don't both you and Tony stay?
Oh, please do, Mr. Kirby. We have all that food and, well, I mean, someone's got
to
eat it.
And it'll give us the opportunity to get acquainted. What do you say?
How about it, Father? Are we staying for dinner?
You'd like to, Tony? Then I'd like to. Very much.
Now, if Alice would send away that cab, Mr. Vanderhall.
What do you say, Alice? We got quite a crowd tonight. Why don't you stay for dinner?
I'm staying, Alice. Don't think the family's all getting to know each other.
Oh, Mr. Kirby. Oh, Tony.
Darling.
Grandpa, you're wonderful.
I've been telling you that for years.
Grandpa, here's a letter for you. It was in the icebox.
Where's it from? Oh, it's the government again.
How do you do, Mr. Kirby?
How do you do?
Well, Miss Sycamore, if you step into my office, I'd like to do a little dictating.
I recall that cab.
Well, well, well.
What is it, Grandpa?
It's the government. They're apologizing. I don't know, I'm a nickel. Turns out, I died 8 years ago.
Why? What do they mean, Grandpa?
Remember Charlie the milkman buried under my name?
Yes.
Well, I walked in there and told them there was a huge mistake. My name was Martin Vanderhoff Jr. And so they apologized, and turns out I might even get a refund.
Why, Grandpa, you old
cook. Sure.
How do you think he's get the income tax again?
I don't know.
Tonight, my friend, you will eat.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Glad to see you.
What has happened to him?
He's relaxing. Play something, Ed.
Everything will be ready in a minute. You can't sit down.
Come on, everybody. Dinner's ready. Come on, Mr. Kirby.
Yes, I'm coming.
dinner.
You are like Russian food, Mr. Kirby.
Oh, but you must be careful of your indigestion.
Nonsense. I haven't had any indigestion.
Well, Miss Sycamore, how's your chips of Adirondacks?
Oh, shut your face, Mr. Kirby.
In Russia, when everybody sits down for dinner...
Quiet, everybody. Quiet. Well, sir, here we are again. We want to thank you for everything you've done for us. Alice and Tony are getting married, and they certainly seem happy about it. The fireworks blew up, but that was Mr. DePina's fault, not yours. Of course, we got our health. But as far as anything else is concerned, we'll leave it to you. Thank you.
Grandpa!
We gotta get started.
He has escaped!
I just want to make a quick special presentation to someone who really put a lot of time and effort into us, and that was our student director. Every year for our fall show, I select one senior drama 4 student who has earned the respect of their peers and myself to assist me with the fall show. They help out with the casting and the rehearsal process and put in a ton of hours. And this year, our senior was Nancy Lopez, so we can give it up for her. And so the cast went ahead and signed a poster, and we got that framed up, and we'd like to present that to you, and thank you so much. Thank you so much for coming. Have a wonderful night. Hopefully we'll see you this evening as well if you want to come on back. Thank you.